Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here. So now it's time to add some reference frame to our station and program. This way, you will be able to have more flexibility on exactly where are our targets and therefore where is our program in the real environment of our robot. Let's jump right into it. Okay, so here is our station. I will bring back the targets, so I'm going to make them visible once again. Bring back the robot to its home position. Okay. For now, all the targets we created are part of the robot base. So here is, if you can see, if I collapse the robot base here in the station tree, all the targets, the robot, the tool are kind of hidden or collapsed, meaning that those are all part of the robot base. If I move the robot base around, so like that here, you can see that the targets and the program will follow. So if I bring the robot, I'm not in the right spot. I need to go back to the first position, double click the first position to reach it, and then launch the path. So just like that here. Perfect. So, and even if I make it, let's say, as a loop, run it, I can move the robot around or move the robot base around, and the target will follow, and the robot program won't even stop while I'm doing so. So I can press escape to save that. If I want to bring back a target to its original, a reference to its original position, there's two ways of doing that. Either I double click on it and just enter zeros everywhere, or I can click here the little three lines or hamburger and then click reset here. Or I can simply, there's a small shortcut if you want to do that, because we oftentimes have to do that real quick. So you can right click here and you have reset here directly in the right click menu, and if you do so, it will bring it back to 000. Cool. Now let's create another reference frame. To do so, you just have to select this button here to the left of add target called add frame. If I press forward slash to show the naming, you will see here it's called frame 2. You can move it the same way as you move the robot or the targets, so pressing alt and moving it around. Perfect. So I'm going to move it right here, let's say. That would make sense. Now, this reference frame was created within the robot base because I had the robot base created when I clicked on add reference frame. So if I do that here, you'll see the new frame will be created here underneath the robot base. If I don't select any frame and I create a frame, it will be created right in the station, so it will be a child just of the station, not of the frame. So now that the frame 2 is part of the robot base, I can rename it. So let's call it simply frame rectangle, just like that. I would like to have all the targets part of that frame, so I'm going to select all the targets, right click, change support, and then I will click on frame rectangle. It could be tempting to select all of those and just drag and drop them here. It would work, but it wouldn't give you the result you're expecting. So if I right click, change support, frame rectangle, it will keep the absolute position of the targets and simply change the parent related to it, so link to it. If I did the drag and drop, it would have kept the relative position with the reference frame and applied it to the new parent. So if I select all of those, drag and drop it to the robot base, you will see that all the targets are now here. Why? Because if you take a look from the top, the positions, and I can, let's say, make the robot invisible and the tool invisible, the position they were with respect to reference frame rectangle here is the same as the position they are now with respect to the robot base. So this is a relative position. So if you just drag and drop, the relative position will be kept. If you select, right-click, change support, select another reference frame, the absolute position is kept, so only the parent is changed. So, oops, select all of those, right click, change support frame. Gonna bring back the robot, bring back the tool. Cool. So that's the first thing. Now, if I move frame rectangle around, you will see that the target will follow. If I move it, if I activate it, so I can activate it, because for now, only the robot base is activated. To know which robot, which frame is activated, you can look at the little green dot here. So the green dot will show which frame is activated and will show which tool is activated. You can also double click the robot and see here which tool is activated and which frame is activated. And you can select from one to the other. So this is a method to switch from one activated frame to the other. Or you can right click and active reference frame. It will flip or switch the green dot from one to the other. If you move the frame around, you will see that if the target gets out of reach, you will see the little warning sign appearing, showing that those targets can't be reached by the robot anymore. If I run the program now, it will run the program here. Why is it the case? This is because, again, here if we look at our program and we're going to press escape to stop it, if we read our program, we can see the first thing we have is set reference frame, and we are referring to the robot base. In this case now, the targets that we need to work with aren't part of the reference frame base. They are part of frame rectangle, so we need to change that. To change that, fairly easy, right click, set reference frame, set reference linked, in fact, and then we can select frame rectangle. This way, when this one is executed, it will be the one we actually run. So that's great. Last little thing here in the robot tab, if you click on, double click on each instruction, one after the other, oops, I skipped corner two, that kind of shows you what I wanted to show you. So if you double click on one instruction, you can just execute that instruction step by step here, just like that. Cool. And if you double click on rectangle, you have the slider at the bottom. And if you use the slider, you can kind of rewind the program and move from one end of the program to the other. And it will show you in the station tree what motion is currently be run. Just like that. Okay, that's everything for this video. In the next one, we will quickly explore the robot and target configurations. This is a very important topic. It's the kind of topic that you can go a long time without knowing, but if you don't, it will cause you some issues that you'll have a hard time recovering from. So I do think it's a very important topic. I hope this one helped, and I hope to see you in the next one.